currently 2-1 in this league with Abzan, Demonic Pact. See what round four brings. So here's a little bit of an inconvenient hand because my enters the battlefield tapped lands don't produce green mana, so I can't have that convenient tapped land and then tapped land one drop draw. I think I'm still just going to play Shambling Vents, have a little more information to work with when I cast Oath of Nissa later in the game. So Shambling Vent on my opponent's side. I've seemed to have played all, sort of grindy control matchups. I guess my first round opponent was playing the four-color Collected Company deck, but even those games played out in a slow, grindy fashion. I'll be happy if round five I get to play against White Weenie or White Green or something like that, just to take this deck for a spin against a wider variety of opponents. Okay, so what now? I wonder if I can assume that my opponent saw black-white. I probably don't have enough information to draw that conclusion. With these three cards, my opponent could still be playing Abzan, Esper Dragons, Mardu. I don't know. So I'm not sure yet if I should be casting the Wasteland Strangler. Well, whatever my opponent's deck is, probably doesn't have a ton of weenie creatures, so it's going to be a long time before my opponent plays out one that I can Silk Wrap and one that I can Wasteland Strangler. I'm just going to put this creature into play and see what happens. Wasteland Strangler, I have to say, has been pretty bad in the matchups I've gotten so far. I was excited about the card, but has not really proven its worth. Well, I'll get in for three. That's fine. Getting to trade with a card like that that has so much late game power, totally fine with. It probably means my opponent has a second copy in hand. Wow, I'm just missing so much with the Oath of Nissa. I think with 38 hits in my deck, the odds should be somewhere lower than 10% that I miss with Oath of Nissa. I had done some rough math earlier and don't have it in front of me, but it should be a lot lower than 10%, actually. It should be closer to, like, 4 or 5%. It's a little better. I don't think I want to attack into Grasp of Darkness at this stage in the game. The life is not worth a lot to me. I just have to settle in and be ready for a grindy match. What I really need is to actually stick a Demonic Pact. That hasn't happened in several matches at this point. Since round one, I don't think it's happened. Okay, so there's a Gideon. If I draw a land, it's not the land I was hoping to draw. Not too sure what to do here. Guess I just cast Sylvan Advocate. I think I'm going to grab a Swamp. Cast Sylvan Advocate. And I suck the Evolving Wilds there because I would want to do it at end of turn, but then my Sylvan Advocate would be temporarily vulnerable to Grasp of Darkness, so just better to main phase it, not leave that window. This game's getting ugly. At least I can kill Obnixilis. So I silk wrap the knight, and I attack Obnixilis. And then if my opponent has a bad hand, and I draw Anguished Unmaking for that Gideon, then I can continue playing. Guessing my opponent probably just has Secure the Wastes here. Secure the Waste is pretty much lethal. I have Tragic Arrogance, but Ormondal is going to be pretty bad for me here. Gideon Emblem would also be bad for me. Or my opponent just attacking with Gideon would be bad for me. I draw Angelic Purge. Alright. That'll do. I'm going to sideboard the same way I did last match, with the exception that I'm going to keep the Stasis Snare in my deck. So out with this stuff. Wasteland Strangler is pretty bad. Okay. Well, I don't really know how this matchup is supposed to play out. I did win last round, but game one of last round, my opponent had missed land drops for a while. I think that realistically, game one's probably bad for me, but post-sideboard's probably good for me because my deck is just a bit more threat-dense and Virulent Plague shuts off a lot of what my opponent can do. And it's just easier for me to neutralize what my opponent can do than the other way around. Also, the eight creature lands is valuable. But yeah, I haven't really gotten Demonic Pact into play very much at all in this video. It was really good in game two of round one, but other than that, it's either just been taken out of my hand or killed with Anguished Unmaking, whatever it might be. Here we go. Here's a hand where maybe I can get Demonic Pact to work for me. She's got to hit a fourth land. Is the key. My opponent could take the Angelic Purge and try to strand me with my own Demonic Pact, but I don't think that's a great plan. Wow, that's actually what my opponent's going for. Well, this is an annoying situation because I have to plan for the scenario where I don't hit a fourth land, in which case the Gideon might just kill me too fast. I think I'm going to take away Gideon here. I don't really know. I could see a case for not the Obnixilus, but any of the other three cards. But I'm going to take Gideon just to try my best to ensure the game goes a little longer. Who could have predicted that I would draw a tapped land on turn four? Okay, my opponent's off to the slow start as well. It may have been right for my opponent to just leave up mana for an end of turn Anguished on Making. I don't really know. Top, though. My opponent is Anguished on Making Obnixilus. I don't like this play very much for my opponent because I'm just going to Helix it and attack with a creature land. Or even better, I can now use Sorin to finish off Obnixilus. Maybe I should have just attacked with the creature land. You want to get value out of Sorin. You want to get like card advantage out of Sorin against a deck with Ruinous Path and Anguished on Making. But it's the game's tempo is a little bit important in this game, in the sense that my opponent has certainly not going to have four Anguished on Making Ruinous Path cards to kill all four of my troublesome permanents. So the faster I can get them out, the slower my opponent can find answers to them. I don't know. It's debatable. For now, I need to find an answer to my Demonic Pact. Okay. So I certainly suspect Secure the Waste for my opponent, so it might be a good idea to play a Virulent Plague before the Westvale Abbey can come active, but really, I think my priority is to find an answer to the Demonic Pact, which, if my opponent transforms Westfield Abbey and I find Angelic Purge, that's the ideal scenario. I definitely need to cast this other one because I need the divination with it and try to find an answer to my pact. And the question is just whether I play the Advocate or whether I play the Virulent Plague as my second card. I guess at worst, or at, you know, even in the case scenario where I find an answer to Ormondal, it can attack and kill Sorin. So I do want to cast the Plague, I believe. Remember, I boarded out Tragic Arrogance, so and my opponent transgressed the mind one of my purges, so I am down to having only 7 ways to remove Demonic Pact, and I'm only going to have 3, 2, 4 draw steps to find it. Although I also have the backdoor possibility of just killing my opponent. So what I can do here is use this one to divination this turn, and if I brick off, I can next turn stack the triggers so that I maybe deal the last 4 damage before I lose the game. So I would like you to discard 2 cards. I would like to draw 2 cards. Yes, there's an answer. I would like to plus 1. So I'm working with as much as 8 mana here. Definitely 3 of it's going to be used to cast Anguished Unmaking. Wouldn't mind casting the other Demonic Pact. I mean, my opponent surely has Secure the Wastes, right? Otherwise, there's no way he or she would cast Anguish Unmaking on the Virulent Plague. So really going for the Ormondal play. But that doesn't really change anything for me, since I have to use the Anguish Unmaking on my own Demonic Pact. Unless I want to make a play where I try to get in a couple more damage and win the game on my upkeep, but that seems unnecessarily risky. So why don't I just cast another Demonic Pact? I can also go transgress. Advocate, Anguish Unmaking. But no, I like Demonic Pact, Anguished Unmaking. All right, so no surprises here. I think my opponent wants to make an Ormondal, which is a fine play. I mean, it puts me in the spot where I have to have multiple exile target permanent effects. Sure. And probably is coming after Sorin. That's fine. Sorin did his job. So now the old one mind rots. No, the old one mind rots. The new one divinations. More demonic pacts. So at what point do I have to worry about my life total? Not just yet, I don't think. Can play Obnixilis and Demonic Pact. Or I can play Oath of Nissa, Sylvan Advocate, Demonic Pact. Obnixilis doesn't do that much in the face of an Ormondal. So why don't I start with Oath? Interesting. Nissa is just basically the same card, but cheaper here. So I'll take that. Yeah. Play Nissa. Transform plus. Hit a swamp. That's perfect. Just keep developing that board. I can't race the Ormondal anymore, so I have to find. I really have to find Angelic Purge. I'm going to get to see. I guess probably about four cards on my turn. And got to find a Purge or at least an Anguish Unmaking. I board out Tragic Arrogance, which would be pretty good in this board state. Oh, I'll leave you with a Warrior token, get rid of all my Pacts. Alright. I'll just Helix this Warrior token. Helix my opponent, and I'll Divination. Come on, Angelic Purge. Alright, that's Anguish Unmaking, that's good. Wow. can I actually race? Is there any way? So how much mana do I have? 5, 10 mana, possibly 11. 3 of it definitely for Anguish Unmaking. My opponent can use Blighted Fen on me. So what's the play here? I have 10 or 11 mana. I'm going to activate Shambling Vent, and I'm going to go to combat. This is good. This is what I was hoping would happen. Now I'm going to activate my tapped Hissing Quagmire, sacrifice that one. At least my life total is not in danger. It's really just that I have to not die to my pact, and I have to eventually find an answer to that Ormondal. But that's... I mean, I could even just race it. I can just put enough power and toughness in on the battlefield that it doesn't matter. But if I ever find Angelic Purge, I'm out of the woods. I'm going to win this game. discard two cards. 4 damage. All right, well, I can either have 11 mana. I can either attack with for 12. That's not going to work. I have to cast Obnixilus and draw into an answer to my pact. It's the only way. Come on, luck. I'm going to die to my own pact. Man. Maybe I flew a little too close to the sun here. Shame, my deck was operating so well in this game, but maybe I should not have sideboarded out both Tragic Arrogances, or maybe I should have one more answer card in my sideboard for when I do board one out. At least I get to go out on my own terms. Okay, I'll be back for the fifth and final round.